again. We're in the mining space this morning here at Proactive Investors in London, and we're talking to Michael Carvill, who's CEO of Kenmare Resources. Michael, a warm welcome to Proactive.
Thanks very much.
Tell us the Kenmare story then. You're in Mozambique, aren't you?
Yeah, we're a mining company. We mine titanium minerals in Mozambique, northern Mozambique. We've been there for a long time. Company started commercial production in 2010. We expanded in 2013 through 2017. And we're now producing about 7% of the world's supply of titanium feedstocks.
Now, you mentioned titanium, but there's also another couple of words that have cropped up in my research on your company, mineral sands. What is that and what's it used for?
Mineral sands is a general category of the type of mineral that we mine, and that includes titanium dioxide minerals, which are called ilmenite and rutile, which are the actual minerals we mine. But in addition to that, we also have a co-product of zircon mineral, which is sold to the ceramics industry. The titanium minerals are sold to make titanium pigment, which in turn makes paint, plastics, fabrics, anything with color or opacity. As we look around the studio, every single surface, even our clothes, have titanium pigment in them. The pen you're writing with, the ink you're writing, the paper you're writing on, all has titanium pigment in it. So as the world grows more wealthy, we use more of it, and therefore its consumption grows according to world GDP.
So your trade is directly related to GDP, and of course, living standards are going up, aren't they, particularly in China?
Yes. So our trade is related to GDP, but there are also sub-segments and areas within the titanium feedstock industry which are growing more strongly. And we actually happen to be in one of those sectors where change in technology, particularly employed in China, has meant that there is a more strongly growing demand for the materials that we produce than titanium pigment generally.
What other geographies are you operating within?
Well, our mine exists only in northern Mozambique. We've only got one mine that's located in Nampula province in northern Mozambique. But historically, we have sold about 30% of our products to North America, 30% to Europe, 33% to Europe, and 33% to Asia, mainly China. Now, China, because of these changes in technology and because China is growing more strongly than the other regions, that has grown and will continue to grow. And so we see ourselves, as we expand, and we are in the process of a 35% expansion at the moment. We've been spending about $150 million over the last 18 months. And 2020 is a big year of transition as these projects come through into completion, leaving us with an expansion of about 35% production in 2021. And a lot of that additional supply will go to China.
So that's how you've justified the spend, all that new business coming from China and other parts of the world as well. And that's why you've built a new plant.
Yeah, the demand is there. We see demand growing as GDP grows and as a sub-segment grows even more strongly. And yet there has been little additional supply entering the market. In fact, because it's a depletive, mining is always depletive, and resources get finished and closed down. And consequently, supply is actually reducing rather than growing. And so therefore, it's an ideal opportunity for us to make a brownfield investment, which is a lower capital intensity investment than building a new mine, and then take some of that additional demand. Why not?
So production then has increased from Kenmare, and he's also mentioned to me a note about reduction in costs as well.
The business is about 80% fixed cost. So as we increase our production, the cost per ton reduces. You know, we produce more tons and divide our total operating cost by more tons, so our cost per ton goes down quite dramatically. And so therefore our margin will expand dramatically as we complete these projects in 2020. And in 2021, we will have a significantly reduced operating cost per ton, which will put us in the first quartile of the world cost curve.
So this next 12 to 24 months, critical for Kenmare then, 2020 a year of transition and 2021 a year on building on that.
Well, yeah, it's sort of like this not even 12 to 24 months, this year, the next 10 months really sees the completion of all of our projects. And from that point onwards, it's really mining more material and selling it.
A word about dividends then, as investors begin to build a picture of what you're up to. I believe that's already been talked about and paid out.
Well, we've paid the first part of our maiden dividend in October. The second part of that gets paid, I think, in March. We have announced a dividend policy of 20%, of a minimum of 20%. And since we're in this very heavy capital spend period at the moment, we're limiting it to 20% of profits. But we expect to increase beyond that as we limit our capital spend on our revenues and EBITDA increases.
So in a couple of sentences then, why is it a good time for investors to take a position on Kenmare?
Because a significant period of project development is coming to a close, and the rewards for that are just over the horizon. The market is particularly positive towards the materials that we produce. We're seeing rising costs, and because we are not paying a dividend, and that dividend will increase. I think that those are all good things for investors, and I would hope that if anybody makes an investment in the company at this stage, it will be a well-rewarded investment.
Well, come back to us, of course, with updates, but for the moment, Michael Carvill, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you very much.